Alright guys, I am back. So let's try and do this. So what I want to do is I want to hit up on the D-pad and select this little set. Then just, you know, put it on lit, lux, whatever.
Inside my head, I can. Hear you. I can hear you inside. You're burning with a white fire. I can't stand it. It's so painful. Thank you. You're the first. You were there at the beginning of everything. Me? No, I... How was that even... How is that possible? Yes. I brought your heart. The Soul Stone. What do you mean? That's not what... Nox. You mean the Yaga? I didn't bring the sisters. I didn't know. They were inside the Soul Stone. And now they're here. With us. That's it, isn't it? Light, dark, dream, nightmare. Together. That's why I needed to go there, to face them, to bring them with me. So, what now? How do we save the dream? How do we save reality? I can't be the one to do that. I'm just a person. Just a person, and you're a god. Or as close as anything can be to God, I guess. I'm not ready for that. Put this on me. I didn't want this. I wanted to be normal. I wasn't asking for a divine purpose. I just didn't know what to do with my life. What happens if I say yes? Who do I become? And what about me? What becomes of me? I understand. Of course, I trust you. How can I not? You made all of this. Without the dream, there's nothing. And there never was. If the dreamer stops dreaming, there's nothing. Forever. So if you're... If we are one, then the dream is mine. I keep it alive. And afterwards, after I'm gone, what then? Okay. Okay. Well, we can't let the universe end, so let's do this. I'm ready.
Zoe? For a moment there, it looked like you were made of light. You were incredibly beautiful.
I'm okay. Dizzy. I have to go back now. Wake up. For real. Face the world. Face the... There are things that... I need to fix things. I can't be asleep any longer.
Okay. Can I come?
No, Crow. You can't.
So you're leaving me here?
You'll be fine. Thanks for everything. I don't think I'll be coming back, but you'll be fine. I promise.
Well, that's great. Left to my own devices, in the Border Mountains, by an inscrutable woman with special powers. Again, if I wasn't so furious, I'd be really, really depressed. You know, I'm so used to being the sidekick, I don't think I can do anything else. But whose sidekick will I... No. Nope, 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 nope. Not happening, big guy. I'm flying back south to find that Kian fellow. I'll be his sidekick. He seems like the sort of guy who appreciates birds.
Do you believe I should have told her all of it? All that I have seen? Perhaps I should have. Perhaps I was wrong not to, but there is only here, only now, nothing more. I am blind. I think I will sit down, rest, sleep, dream of my daughters, long gone, and hope. The future will still be there for them all when I fade to dust.
The answer is no. You should know better than to ask, Saga. I won't risk you getting lost out there, again.
I'll be careful this time, I promise.
It doesn't matter. I am not removing the wards.
I'm 14, Papa. I can take care of myself.
That didn't help your mother.
It's always about her, isn't it? I'm not my mother. Whatever happened to her won't happen to me.
And you know this how? She said the same thing. She wasn't gonna get lost. She was coming right back. I shouldn't worry. I should just stay put and wait for her. I'll remove the wards when you're older. Until then, you are not leaving the house on your own.
That is so unfair. I've been stuck here my whole life. How much longer are we going to-
Until I know that she's not coming back. All right, until I know for sure, because if we leave and she does return,
She's gone. Let her go, Papa. Please.
I'm going upstairs to rest for a bit. Don't play the radio too loud. I'll be back down for dinner.
I can't take this anymore.
I'll show him his wards can't stop me from walking. I just have to, find the wards first. Not easy when only Papa can see them.
Alright, so you gotta get the glasses first.
That's weird. Papa's usually so fastidious about keeping his eyeglasses with him at all times. I'll just borrow them for a minute. Or 12.
Alright. I gotta put the eyeglasses on. Now the goal is to find wards. Follow the instructions below. First ward is in the same room as Harden, and simply look up at the ceiling and interact with the ward.
Oh wow, I see one of the wards. So that's how Papa maintains them. The magic's in his glasses. I mean, of course it is. It's dab magic. Still, it's pretty cool.
Careful! Ow!
Sorry. Sorry, did I break your head?
Yes. Do you have to carry me across the threshold?
We'd be tempting fate if I don't. We need to do this right. Watch your head now. There, we have officially moved in. Welcome home, sweetheart.
My head's hurting.
Let me kiss it. Where does it hurt? There?
That helped. Oh, she's moving. She's kicking, Magnus. Here, give me your hand. Can you feel it? She's happy to be home.
Hello, Saga. Welcome home, baby girl.
Balance! So that's what the wards are made of. Fragments of the past. Memories. No wonder they're so strong. They're charged with powerful emotions. Some might be red herrings, though, to make the wards harder to crack. I need to untangle the specific memories that tie the wards together. Easy.
Okay. So that's one through the one over here at the window. Set the hand icon on them. Okay. Now scratches. And photograph. Alright, to find a second ward, I'm gonna put those eyeglasses on. Go to the dining room and open the door.
The house will draw us both back if we ever get lost. That's what it does. What it's for.
And you're sure we can trust it?
Are you questioning my building skills?
I don't want to lose you again.
You won't. It's safe to leave, Etta. You'll find your way back and we'll be safe here. Both of us. All three of us. When that one arrives.
Oh, and not a moment too soon. I am so over being pregnant. Speaking of which, I'm starving again.
I'll make stew.
Please don't.
Trow. Trow.
That's the final ward. Uncle Galeth helped put these wards up after the last time I went walking. Papa claims they protect us, but all they do is keep me from opening doorways. They don't trust me.
She's so perfect. I could stare at her for hours.
Sometimes I wake up in the middle of the night and I go in here just to look at her. She is perfect. Even before she wakes up?
I have to. While the paths are still there. They're stable now, but that might change. I can't risk waiting. Watch over her for me, okay? Keep her safe.
Of course. Always and forever. I promise.
Come here. I love you. Always and forever. And I'll be back. I pinky promise.
Alright, so school books.
That's all the wards, and Papa's still asleep. He won't be happy when he wakes up. I need to get out of here before then, or he might lock me in the downstairs for a week. So I'll just open a doorway and... It's not working. Why is it not working? All the wards are gone. What's stopping me now? My chest feels warm. Wait, am I glowing?
Alright, press up and set the pendant with X and then square to open.
This is for you, Saga. It belonged to my mother. Keep it close to your heart and know that I'll always be thinking of you, no matter where I am. Even if I'm... You don't understand a word I'm saying, but you will remember when you're most needed. Don't let anything or anyone hold you back. All worlds, all of time are yours to explore. And as long as you are this, I will find you. I promise.
Thank you. I love you. Goodbye.
Alright, so now to get the next trophy, the girl who walks between worlds. Just simply go through it.
Saga, where in the world are you?
Saga! Lawrence, no, please, no. Lars, well, don't take her from me. Please don't. I can't do this again. I cannot do this again. Please. Saga.
Fall chapters. All your decisions have been recorded for Book 5. The actions and decisions you have made in Book 4 have already changed towards your journey in important ways. These decisions will be remembered and they will decide how your journey continues in Book 5. This is a summary of a few of the choices you have made and consequences that may have in the future. Alright, that's Keon. Since I remembered to return the pipe worker's tools, Aldrich was not arrested by the Azadi. He remains a free man. Your decisions in Book 3 have played out in Book 4 and will continue to have repercussions in the future final chapters. 56%. Alright, Zoe, I told Brian Westhouse about what I was doing in the abode and about where I'm going. Should I have done that? I'm sure I can trust him. There will be repercussions up to decision, final book, 40% did that. I let Westhouse stay in the abode. I'm sure he won't do any damage to the property or steal anything, but it feels a bit weird to not lock up after myself. 32% chose that. That's Gion. Against Shepard's wishes, I brought Liko with me to Gion. He was a good companion and he proved himself useful, but I hope his absence from Wakura did not cause the resistance any problems. Lies are in the balance, and friends or allies will live or die based on your decisions. 73.5 chose that. Liko and I had time to connect during our journey to Gion. I feel we're closer now, and that we may even become friends in the future. Your relationship with Liko has been affected by your choice. 81.5% chose that. Ine was seriously hurt in the attack on the enclave, but Naane was there to heal her wounds. The Zed will survive. Ine's fate is closely tied to Naane. Your choices in Book 2 will play out in the final chapter. 68.6% chose that. So it's a good thing we didn't turn around as a traitor, because I've been wanting Ine to be dead. Back to Zoe. I revealed some of my darkest secrets to the Yaga in order to make her give me the Soul Stone. And now, it's like they never happened, like they were merely dreams slowly fading to nothing. Those memories will remain with you or forever fade to nothing, depending on your decision. 77.5% made that choice. Alright guys, that's the end of Book 4. I will do the next book here soon, or if I've already done it, and you know, just go ahead and start the next book. But I will see you guys in the next video.